Hello students, in the last videos we discussed about matrices and determinants. In this video we will learn to solve system of linear equations using Cramer's rule. In lower classes we use different methods to solve linear equations in two variables, say x and y, but those methods are no longer applicable if the number of variables increases to 3, 4 or more. In such cases, determinants are quite helpful to get the solution. Cramer's rule is one of these methods. It is very interesting method to solve the linear equations. Let us discuss the Cramer's rule to solve linear equations in three variables x, y and z. Let the general system of linear equations in three variables be a1 into x plus b1 into y plus c1 into z is equal to d1, a2 into x plus b2 into y plus c2 into z is equal to d2, a3 into x plus b3 into y plus c3 into z is equal to d3. Let us first write the determinant delta by taking the coefficients of x, y and z as shown in the slide and then solve it. Now we will write the determinant for x. To write it, we will replace the first column of the coefficient matrix by the element of column matrix from the right hand side of given equations. Similarly, we can write determinant delta 2 for y and delta 3 for z. Now the solution of x, y and z depend upon the value of delta. If delta is equal to 0, then either no solution or infinitely many solutions will exist. If delta is equal to 0, then unique solution is x is equal to delta 1 by delta, y is equal to delta 2 by delta, z is equal to delta 3 by delta. The hierarchy of Cramer's rule can easily be understood from this diagram. So the procedure for Cramer's rule is this. One more point to discuss here is that the given system of equations is consistent if the solution exists, and system is said to be inconsistent if its solution does not exist. Let us apply Cramer's rule to solve linear system of equations in two variables and three variables. First, taking example in two variables, solve x plus y is equal to 7 and 2 into x minus y is equal to 5 using Cramer's rule. Let us first write delta by taking coefficients of x and y. On solving, delta is equal to minus 3, which is non-zero. So system has unique solution. Now write the determinant delta 1 for x. Replace the coefficients of x1, 2 in determinants delta by right hand side value 5, 7 respectively. Solving it is minus 12. Similarly, delta 2 is equal to minus 9. So the value of x is equal to delta 1 by delta, which is equal to 4, and y is equal to delta 2 by delta, which is equal to 3. Hence, we solve the solution. Let us take example in three variables. Solve x plus y plus z is equal to 20. 2 into x plus y minus z is equal to 23. 3 into x plus y plus z is equal to 46. As in the last question, we will write the determinants delta by taking coefficients x, y, z as shown in the slide, and solving delta is equal to minus 4, which is not equal to 0. Since delta is non-zero, it will have a unique solution, and we proceed to solve delta 1, delta 2, delta 3. On solving, delta 1 is minus 52, delta 2 is minus 8, and delta 3 is minus 20. So, value of x is equal to delta 1 by delta, which is equal to minus 52 by minus 4, which gives us 13. Y is equal to delta 2 by delta, which is equal to minus 2. And Z is equal to delta 3 by delta, which is equal to 5. We can verify the answer by plugging the value in any one given equation. Thank you.